This year, Charles Schulz will start his 30th year of creating Charlie Brown. This season will also be Charlie Brown's 15th year on network television. Please join us tonight as we proudly present the greatest highlights in Charlie Brown's career.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Charlie Brown. Happy birthday to you.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to our celebration for Charlie Brown. And here to open our show with an assist from Broadway star Don Potter is someone who has decided to be the head beagle for this entire production. Here's Snoopy.
I'm gonna be the big bow wow. Wait till they see the old dog now. Stealing the show, my mom wouldn't know her. I'm gonna be a VIP. Hey, look at me, a VIP. Thoroughbred sort, a very important pup. Three, no. Two, no. I'm numero uno. Are they ready for you? No. Ooh. I'm gonna be the big bow wow. You're gonna see them all kowtow. Name on my door, a rug on my floor, and how. Class, yes. Style, yes. Out front by a mile, yes. Look me up in the new Who's Who. Bigger and Rin Tin Tin and Lassie. Bigger and Pluto, twice as classy. Little mistake, it's time that I take my bow. Gonna be hearing from Snoopy. Pardon my beagle, but
whoopee!
Now I'm the
is Snoopy's home, number one Snoopy place in Santa Rosa, California, just an hour's drive north of San Francisco. In a few months, Snoopy's creator, Charles Schulz, will start drawing his comic strips for the 30th consecutive year. And for half that time, 15 years, the Charlie Brown characters have also starred on network television. Sparky, how has it felt to have your comic strip characters come alive on network television over the past 15 years?
It's been very gratifying. When I think of all the wonderful letters which we receive from families saying that this is one of the few times when they can actually sit down in front of a TV set together, it has to be just simply gratifying.
Absolutely. Out of the 16 or 17 specials that you've done so far, which have been your favorite scenes?
I recall the wrist wrestling championships which take place in Petaluma, which is not very far from here. And Bill Melendez did a marvelous scene where Lucy and Snoopy take part in a wrist wrestling contest, and it certainly has to be one of the funniest things that I think Bill Melendez ever animated. Another favorite scene involves Snoopy and Schroeder.
Shows, which is your personal favorite?
Well,
A lot of people seem to like the Halloween show, especially the part where Charlie Brown gets rocks in his bag instead of candy.
Three cookies. Hey, I got a package of gum.
I got a rock.
But I guess my favorite still has to be the Christmas show, because that's when the whole thing got started. And by now, it's been translated into 15 other languages.
Espera, antes de que empiece la consulta, debes pagar. Son 5 centavos. Qué lindo suena. Adoro este sonido de banquero. Me encanta el dinero contante y sonante. Escucha cómo suena este dinero, Carlitos. Es la linda voz de las monedas cantarinas.
I understand that on your new TV show, Charlie Brown is going to enter the decathlon.
Yes. It's to be called You're the Greatest, Charlie Brown, and he enters the Junior Olympics.
Is he finally going to win something, that poor little guy?
Well, I'd like to reveal the ending to you, but I don't think we even know how it's going to come out.
There are different ways of training dogs. I've been reading about the shake and throw method of training puppies. A mother dog can't hit a puppy, so she picks it up, shakes it, and then drops it.
I can't believe a puppy would learn anything from that. On the other hand, I guess you might learn a little.
And this is where it all happens. Charles Schulz's studio at number one Snoopy Place. The desk at which he's drawn over 10,000 comic strips over the last 3 decades. Sparky, I'm sure a lot of people would like to know the answer to the question, where do you come up with all these terrific ideas?
It's probably impossible for anyone to do a comic strip over a long period of time without really drawing upon your own experiences. And of course, I think back upon growing up in St. Paul, Minnesota, and all of the dumb things that I did in school. But I also have to admit that my own kids have given me a few ideas.
Anything specific that you can think of?
I always think about our youngest daughter, Jill, who came up to me one day and she said, I just discovered something. If you hold your hands upside down, you get the exact opposite of what you pray for.
I understand you're an avid reader, and you have all these books back here to prove that. Do you ever get many ideas from what you read?
Well, I remember I was reading a sports magazine one day, and there was an article in it about Alaskan sled dogs. And it occurred to me, wouldn't it be funny and disastrous if poor Snoopy were hijacked and were then forced to become part of an Alaskan sled dog team? And it was this idea that prompted an entire television special.
Charlie Brown involves sports, and Charles Schulz is an active participant in sports almost every day of his life. He built this beautiful ice arena so that he and thousands of others could skate and play ice hockey. Each year, he hosts the Senior Olympics hockey tournament with teams from the United States and Canada.
This is an invitational hockey tournament, and the minimum age for players is 40. Now, on my team, you have to be 55 or over. So the three teams in this bracket will be playing a round robin, and I think the Canadians are going to give us a lot of trouble.
You're tough.
Yes.
But his real love now is tennis, and not even these interviews stopped him from playing his daily three or four sets.
Run, run. Good. Moving in.
Keep moving. Keeps you warm. Hey, Sparky, when you're out here playing, do you ever get to relax? I mean, do you ever get to forget about the strip?
Oh, the playing of the game is relaxing, but I must admit that the cartoon never completely leaves my mind, because I can almost be assured that just the action of playing will produce one funny idea about tennis. Good shot.
Good shot.
Get that one. Look out.
Score, 6-5 in Snoopy's favor. Ball. Football. Love, 15.
I discovered that jogging is also part of a Charles Schulz day.
That's enough of that.
That's fun. Do you ever come up with any ideas while you're jogging out here in this beautiful weather?
Yes, as a matter of fact, I think I've drawn three or four Sunday pages where Snoopy's been jogging, and I've been kind of proud of those.
Those were the strips where the various parts of Snoopy's body were talking to him as he jogged along.
When do we go home? Did you ever hear anyone complain more than feet? Only backs. Just because I'm the right foot, why do I have to do all the work? What do you mean? I'm the one who does all the cornering. Without us legs, you feet would be nowhere. How can we concentrate up here with you guys talking all the time? Oh, sure. It's those stupid brains bragging again. They take credit for everything. Have you ever thought about why we're doing this? Just to keep the heart in shape. Just remember, boys, if I go, you all go. That's scary. Shut up and keep running. As my two sons grew up, Monty started making model airplanes, and this is what gave us the idea for the Red Baron. And then my other son, Craig, took up motorcycle racing, and this gave us the idea for the motocross show.
Charlie Brown in the NASCAR Marvel! at the vets. They put me at the vets. The motocross. I've got to get back to the motocross.
But Phyllis, cartooning is still sitting in a room by yourself, hour after hour, day after day, trying to draw funny pictures.
For 30 years.
It's kind of depressing.
Do you ever get out of here to go out and do research?
I used to say that I never went any place unless I could be home by noon, but I must admit that a little while ago, we were doing research for a movie where the kids were going to be on a raft trip. So we went down the Rogue River on rubber rafts in order that I could experience the same thing that Charlie Brown was going to have to do. Bon voyage, Charlie Brown, and don't come back. We're going to send the kids over to London, where Snoopy will play at Wimbledon, and from London, they're going across the channel to Normandy.
Why in the world would you take Charlie Brown to Normandy?
Well, they're all going to be going to France as exchange students, and the adventure in the movie all takes place in this northern part of France.
Sparky traveled back to Normandy to research the new film.
In the movie, Charlie Brown gets a mysterious note to come stay at the Chateau Balvoisin. Now, I was actually billeted with my platoon at this chateau in World War II. So it was quite an emotional experience for me to go back there 35 years later to do research for the movie. The name means, strangely enough, the Chateau of the Bad Neighbor. And Charlie Brown and Linus run into all kinds of mysterious things there. And I also revisited the cafe where we had first met some of the French townspeople over 35 years ago. And of course, it was a real thrill to recall those times.
Coffee, tea, or milk? Coffee, tea, or milk? Coffee, tea, or milk, sir? Finished, sir?
Charles Schulz has drawn nearly 11,000 comic strips over the past 30 years. Here, as he sketches in his studio, are his thoughts about each of his characters.
It has been said that Charlie Brown is sort of an everyman. And I suppose this is kind of true. But he's also based a good deal upon myself. I think and I hope that a lot of readers recognize a little bit of themselves in Charlie Brown. Because, after all, most of us are much more acquainted with losing than we are winning. Losing is something that we've all experienced, and unfortunately, very few of us ever get to be club champion. In spite of the fact that Charlie Brown loses all the time, we have to admire him for one thing, and this is that he never stops trying.
This is a steep hill, Snoopy. But we're not afraid, are we? We know that no matter what dangers lie ahead, we can face them if we stick together.
Thank you.
Beethoven is going to affect someone.
Snoopy probably represents the dream of a lot of people who would like to be club champion or to be a world-famous flying ace. But there's another quality about Snoopy that I think makes it work, and this is a quality of innocence combined with maybe a little bit of egotism. You put those two qualities together, and I think you have trouble. Of all of the things that I have thought of, I believe that Linus and his security blanket is the best. I think this has had more impact than anything that has been in Peanuts. And of course, the term security blanket is now part of the American language. I'm very proud of this. I'm very proud of the character of Linus himself. I think he is the most well-rounded personality in the group.
Linus, do you think I should have my ears pierced?
I have a better idea. Why don't you have your mouth boarded up?
Lucy's fun to draw. I like giving her the wild expressions of anger and terror and anxiety that she frequently has. Lucy is fun to work with because she has this violence within her, but Lucy's flaw is her love for Schroeder. And when this weakness shows up, then Lucy is rather vulnerable.
You and your stupid old Beethoven! By golly, I'll show you! There! What do you think of that? Never get married.
The idea for Peppermint Patty came when I walked through the living room one day and I saw a little dish of candy sitting there, and I thought that the name of the candy would make a good character in a comic strip. It just may be that Peppermint Patty does represent a new trend among kids to be more independent and to speak out.
I'm awake. No problem, ma'am. Just a little whiplash. King Louis II? Well, if you subtract King Louis XIV from King Louis XVI, you get King Louis II. You don't?
I was thumbing through a music book one day, and I just thought it would be interesting to show a complicated musical score in such a simple thing as a comic strip. So I chose Schroeder, who was just a tiny baby in the strip at that time, to be the one who would be playing the toy piano. And it worked so well that it became one of the most important themes that has ever been in the strip. Schroeder is not a musical snob because, after all, he's a catcher on the baseball team. But I suppose he's kind of serious. But you'd be serious, too, if you had somebody like Lucy chasing you all the time.
I think it would be very romantic if someday you gave me a single perfect rose, or a carnation, or even an old dandelion.
How about a handful of crabgrass?
I'll take it.
I think I have been drawing birds in the strip for, at least 10 years. But it took me that long, really, to develop this little guy who eventually became known as Woodstock, naturally after the rock festival. And strangely enough, a lot of people wrote in and complained about him. They didn't like him. They thought that Woodstock and Snoopy were taking over the strip too much, but I kind of stuck by him, and now I think Woodstock is one of the favorites in the strip.
She was originally meant to be kind of a minor character. Charlie Brown's little sister, Sally, has really come on to be one of the favorite characters. Of course, she never really knows quite what is going on, and this gets her into a lot of trouble at school.
Who is the father of Henry IV? I could not possibly care less.
Oops, I'm sorry. I apologize.
That was just a gut reaction.
Yes, ma'am?
Oh, my report.
Yes, ma'am.
My report today is on dinosaurs. The largest dinosaur that ever lived was the Bronchitis. It soon became extinct. It coughed a lot.
So all these individual personalities have somehow become a close-knit group over the years.
What he'd like to do for Charlie Brown's birthday. It seems that one of his favorite songs is Supper Time from the play You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown, but he's never been allowed to do it personally. So here's Snoopy doing Supper Time.
It's supper time. Yeah, it's supper time. Oh, it's supper time, very best time of day. Do 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 do. Supper time. Oh, it's supper time. And when supper time comes, can supper be far away? Bring on the soup dish, bring on the cup, bring on the bacon and fill me up, cause it's supper, supper time. Wintertime's nice with the ice and snow. Summertime's nice with a place to go. Bedtime, overtime, halftime too. But they just can't hold a candle to my supper time. Oh, yeah. Bring on the hamburg, bring on the bun. Pappy's little puppy knows everyone, cause it's supper.
You know, Sparky, you've had so many great covers through the years. Newsweek, Time, Life, TV Guide. They must have prompted some very cherished memories for you.
Well, they certainly have, and of course, each cover has represented what we might call a milestone in the progress of the comic strip and the television shows and the other projects that we've done.
From a personal standpoint, one of the greatest thrills was being chosen Grand Marshal of the Rose Parade. This was an honor that certainly does not happen too often to comic strip artists.
Liftoff. We have liftoff 49 minutes past the hour.
And we'll see both Snoop and Charlie Brown at 98.25.
Charlie Brown, over.
Right, reading you five by, Charlie Brown.
Oh, Houston, this is Snoopy.
I guess, Sparky, one of your biggest thrills had to be the Apollo 10 moonshot when they named the command module Charlie Brown and the landing module Snoopy.
Yes, because for years, comic strip characters have been going into outer space, and this was the first time when a comic character literally went to the moon.
Of course, over the past 30 years, the awards to Charlie Brown and to Charlie Schulz have been numerous. The television specials have won 4 Emmys, and Schulz himself was twice selected as Cartoonist of the Year by the National Cartoonist Society. His comic strips have also been displayed in the Louvre in Paris and the Smithsonian in Washington, D.C. And a few months ago, he was selected by over 700 comic artists from around the world as the world's outstanding cartoonist for 1978. He and his wife Jeannie journeyed to Montreal, Canada, to the Pavilion of Humor to receive this honor from curator Robert Lapalme. Sparky, how do you react to all these achievements you've won through the years? You just won the world's greatest cartoonist, and I could go on and on.
I try to be very humble, but I don't think I'm good at it. I must admit, however, that I am competitive, and I'm extremely anxious for the strips that I do to be the very best that I can do in each paper each day.
What single idea has brought you the most satisfaction through the years?
Probably the happiness thing. I remember years ago, I was drawing a strip where one of the kids was giving Snoopy a big hug, and at the end, he said, "Happiness is a warm puppy." And it was from that that the book came, and then eventually one of the songs in the play, You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown. Clark Gesner wrote this wonderful song called Happiness, and this has always given me wonderful satisfaction.
And here to sing it are my good friends, Larry Finlayson and Becky Reardon.
Happiness is finding a pencil, piece of a sausage, telling the time.
Happiness is learning to whistle, tying your shoe for the very first time.
Happiness is playing the drums in your own school band. And happiness is walking hand in hand.
Happiness is morning and evening, daytime and nighttime too.
For happiness is anything and anyone at all. That's love by you.
As Charlie Brown starts his 15th season on network television, we thought we'd show you some of the highlights from his long career.
Hey, it's snowing. It's time to hitch up the old sled, Snoopy. You'll pull it, and I'll ride it, okay? Somehow he has the way of taking the fun out of everything.
Here's a gentle reminder. If you throw that snowball at me, I'll break every bone in your stupid body.
Saved by a gentle reminder. Hey, Snoopy, why don't you come into the house? And I'll feed you in here. It's a lot warmer. Why does he have to make such a big deal out of everything? Trapped like a turtle. I can't move. I'm doomed. I'll have to lie here the rest of my life.
And then she told me about this one party they had where they played spin the bottle. Everyone sat in a circle with a milk bottle in the middle. Then the person who was it would spin the bottle like this. Then they'd all sit there and wait for the bottle to stop spinning to see who it would point to.
Boy, this is some team I've got this year. A beagle at shortstop, a second baseman with a blanket, and a left fielder who's still on the bottle.
Are you the catcher?
Of course I'm the catcher. What are you doing?
Nice catch, catcher.
All right, gang. Let's keep awake out there. On the other hand, forget I said anything.
Charlie Brown. You should pitch night games, so when you get undressed by a line drive, all you have to do is put on your pajamas and go to bed. A centimeter? If any centimeters come crawling into this room, I'll step on them.
My beach ball! You let my beach ball get away! It's gone! That ball will float clear to Hawaii. What do you have to say for yourself?
Aloha?
This is what I believe. I believe that the great pumpkin rises out of the pumpkin patch on Halloween night and flies through the air, bringing with him toys for all the children in the world. That's what I believe. What do you think?
I think you have very nice eyes and that you are completely out of your mind. Perfume for me? How nice. Hey, this is a fragrance I've never heard of. Wet Beagle.
Blech. Well, how do you like the hot chocolate I made for you?
It's terrible. It's too weak. It tastes like some warm water that has a brown crayon dipped in it.
You're right. I'll go put in another crayon.
One of the things that we did, Phyllis, that gave me more satisfaction than I think anything we've ever done didn't even involve the characters or the comic strip.
What was that?
We did an ice show not long ago, and my daughter, Amy, skated a feature role in this ice show, and this was something that I was really proud of.
I come to the garden.
Sort of thing, Phyllis, that I think makes everything worthwhile.
Oh, sure.
And of course, like all of us, Snoopy loves to skate too.
Snoopy become a part of Charles Schulz's life?
Not only that, but you might almost say that Snoopy has now gone off and is leading a life of his own in a certain way. I was thinking about the toys. Now, I draw the comic strip each day, and I force Snoopy to do what I want him to do. But if a child is playing with a stuffed Snoopy, Snoopy is now off in this other life, doing things over which I have no control. He's out there leaving, leading his own life.
You feel like he's deserted you?
I think he's run away on me.
And wherever Snoopy goes, Woodstock is usually not far behind.
Oh,
First thing to do at U-Rex is to bathe you.
I hope you like baths, because my doggy has to be real clean. Okay, Rex? Okay, in we go, Rex. Speaking hygienically, we've got to wash away each sleep. Rub-a-dub-a-dub, I'll scrub you in the tub. Oh, how squeaky clean you'll be. Because of fundamental friend dependability, I will disinfect your whole anatomy. When you've got a chump, the scrubs it to your numb. That's fundamental friend dependability. Down, Rex! Heel, Rex, heel! Every little shaggy pup ought to get to gussy up. I will pour the tea just for you and me. Oh, how proper we will be. Cause we got fundamental friend dependability. Fundamental friend dependability. Fundamental friend dependability. Fundamental friend dependability. Fundamental friend dependability.
Sparky, quite a bit of your material has been converted into music through the years.
Yes, of course, we had the two musicals, You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown, and then Snoopy, and all the music from our three feature films. But I guess the music that has become most identified with Charlie Brown has been the music of the late Vince Guaraldi. He composed and he performed all of the music for our first 16 TV shows. And I guess his theme of Linus and Lucy has become a real standard now.
Sometimes Vince even sang some of his own songs.
Joe Cool, back in school, hanging round the water fountain, playing a fool. Joe Cool, take it light. If the principal catches you, you out of sight. Take those shades off, walking round the hall. Joe Cool, making the rounds, checking all the kiddies up and down. Joe Cool, play it straight. If the principal catches you, it's gonna be too late. Yeah.
With the many uses, Sparky, of all the Charlie Brown characters, which ones give you the most satisfaction?
Well, we're starting to develop some things for schools, such as film strips for career education. And we recently did a film for the American Dental Association that will show people the proper way to clean their teeth.
And make sure you brush each tooth carefully. Once you have brushed all your teeth on the outside, you have to brush the inside of each and every tooth, too. Tilt the brush to clean your teeth from the inside. Use up and down strokes here. Finish by brushing back and forth over chewing surfaces of your teeth. Cleaning your tongue with your brush will help your mouth feel fresher.
After all these marvelous years, what do you think Charlie Brown is all about?
Well, for a long time, I was not able to answer that question. But something happened recently that brought it a little more clearly to my mind. My secretary came in one day and she said that that evening her boy had come home from school, slammed the door, threw his jacket down on the couch and said, "Mom, I feel just like Charlie Brown." And all of a sudden it occurred to me, perhaps that's the reason for a character like Charlie Brown. He defines for us feelings that I think all of us have.
Here comes the little red-haired girl to get a drink of water. I'll turn the fountain on for her and impress her with my thoughtfulness. I wonder if I could get transferred to another planet.
Since this is Charlie Brown's birthday celebration, we thought it only appropriate that we do something very special. So we brought back, after 14 years, and reunited the voices of Charlie Brown and Lucy. And the show, I believe, was It's the Great Pumpkin Charlie Brown. Peter Robbins, who played the original Charlie Brown, and Sally Dreyer, who played Lucy. Peter, how did you get Charlie Brown in the first place? You are the original.
That's right. I went out on a call with about 100 other kids, and somehow, luckily, I think I had a strange voice, and they picked me. And I just worked through the first specials, commercials first, and then the Charlie Brown Christmas special was the first one.
Christmas special. And how did you get the part of Lucy, Sally?
I was cast as Violet the very first show. And the producer decided later that I had a particular quality of crabbiness to my voice and decided I'd make a better Lucy.
You're not crabby, are you?
Well, I'm trying not to live up to the image.
Well, I remember watching the show, but somehow I can't remember how the voices would sound just looking at you now. I'm going to close my eyes and see if it all comes back to me, okay?
Okay.
Okay, go.
I don't know, Phyllis. Christmas is coming, but I'm not happy. I don't feel the way I'm supposed to feel. I like sending Christmas cards and getting Christmas presents and all that, but I'm still not happy. I always end up feeling depressed.
You're still a blockhead, Charlie Brown.
Good grief.
I'm convinced. And here's the current cast of Charlie Brown introducing themselves pro football style.
Hi, I'm Casey Cross and I play Marcy.
Hi, I'm Annalisa Bortolini and I play Sally.
Hi, I'm Leticia Ortiz and I play Loris.
Hi, I'm Ronald Hendricks and I play Franklin.
Hi, I'm Danny Anderson and I play Linus.
Hi, I'm Laura Planting and I play Peppermint Patty.
Hi, I'm Erin Skelly and I play Charlie Brown.
Hi, I'm Michelle Muller and I play Lucy.
I'm sure there's a little bit of Snoopy and Charlie Brown and Lucy in all of us, and that's why we're dedicated fans. We want to wish all of the Charlie Brown gang and Charles Schulz many more happy birthdays. Oh, good night, everyone.
I'm gonna be the big bow wow. You're gonna see them all kowtow. Name on my door, a rug on my floor, and how class. Yeah.